One of the best Disney Channel movies, Johnny Tsunami, about a surfer from Hawaii who has to move to the east coast of Vermont and learn how to fit in and snowboard. I could never really tell if this is a surfing movie or a snowboarding movie. You could say both, but this does show way more snowboarding than surfing. But I'll say both because Johnny Tsunami can do it all. Okay, before I get into talking about this movie, one of the main reasons why Johnny Tsunami is one of the best Disney Channel movies is because of its all-star cast. Obviously, Johnny Tsunami made Brandon Baker a mega star from this movie alone, but let's see how many. His dad is Chosen from The Karate Kid Part 2. His grandpa is Shang Tsung from the first Mortal Kombat movie. And the writers of this movie, Doug Sloan and Ann Knapp, who are writers and producers of Power Rangers from Mighty Morphin all the way up into Dino Thunder. His best friend, Sam, is the famous Jet Jackson, and his friend he meets in Vermont is Xenon. You gotta admit, for a Disney Channel movie in 1999, that's a mega star cast. Now, the movie is called Johnny Tsunami because his grandpa got that name for being the best surfer, and so his grandson also gets that name as well and wants to be a great surfer just like him. What makes Johnny such a likable character is he always tries his best to be positive and nice and try to make the best out of any situation. His dad doesn't like that he uses all his time surfing and wants him to focus more on school so he won't turn to Johnny Tsunami and just surf all day. Johnny knows this, but he just likes to surf and have fun. Even when they gotta move across the country because his dad got a new job, he doesn't get super angry, he just shows a little sadness, but sees it as something new. When you see Johnny in school, the bully kids are already picking on him, and instead of taking it as being bullied, he just talks back in a nice way, like when they take his magazine. He just lets them know it's a cool issue and they can borrow it. He really makes any situation, even one that could be scary, into something positive. Same goes with surfing. He can't do his most favorite thing anymore, so he tries something new, what all the kids at his new school do, skiing. He tries to take it on, but doesn't get too well into it, and then he meets Sam, who also snowboards, and that's what he gets more into and wants to learn. He also becomes cool friends with Sam, but here's the problem. So apparently, all the kids who go to the academy school, which is where Johnny goes, has to ski, and the kids who go to the public school, which is where Sam goes, all snowboard. They all have only parts of the mountain they are allowed on, and it's all divided. This is the part of the movie where I'm just like, what kind of town is this? Everyone has to follow these weird rules? Sam explains why about an owner that split the mountain, and ever since then, everybody's followed this rule. Johnny even gets in trouble by the headmaster of the school and tells Johnny he has to decide who will be his friends. His mom does the same reaction as us, the audience. The principal even follows this lame rule that should have never been taken so seriously. We see Johnny is always positive, but this is what breaks him, and him and his dad argue about him and not hanging out with the snowboard kids. Even Emily was starting to get interested in snowboarding as well, but she has to hide it because, especially since her dad is the headmaster. This part of the movie gets so intense. Even Johnny, the coolest kid ever, gets angry and upset. It's tough to watch. He can't even be friends with Sam anymore because he's a snowboarder, so they run away back to Hawaii. You know, that really is messed up. So how will this whole weird divided mountain be fixed? Competition. Brett versus Johnny, and if Johnny wins, everybody can snowboard or ski or any part of the mountain they wish. Johnny Tsunami is such a cool movie. You don't even have to like surfing or snowboarding to like it. Johnny gives off a lot of positive energy, and you can tell he's the kind of person that will be everybody's friend and find the good in everybody and accept you for who you are. But just 8 years later, Johnny returns into he's now 17 years old and now conquered snowboarding and surfing, goes on to take mountain boarding back in Hawaii. The majority of the cast does return, except for a few. But when you know it, the big stars that didn't come back, we were introduced to new stars. It's sad to see Xenon and Jet Jackson not be back. At least Emily wasn't replaced, like with Sam. That's clearly a different person playing Sam. He's alright, but he ain't no Jet Jackson. Johnny meets a new girl named Val, which in 2 years goes on to play the Yellow Ranger, Summer, and Power Rangers RPM. But the coolest new addition to the sequel is Carla. She is Johnny Tsunami's love interest and soon-to-be wife. Not only was she in Karate Kid Part 3, but also from Teen Witch, just two of the best movies to come out of the 80s. Now, Johnny and the rest of the family come back to Hawaii to be there for the big wedding. Carla has a son named Chris who is constantly angry and bitter for having to leave home to move to Hawaii and start a new life. Johnny, throughout the whole movie, tries his best to get along with him since they will be family soon. How does Johnny get into mountain boarding? Chris keeps wanting to hang out with these kids who all mountain board, and since Chris is really into it, Johnny decides to try it out. It's almost the same thing from the first movie. He falls, but through the whole movie, he gets better at it. These kids are all almost the same as the ones in the first. They all tease them and make fun of them and make them do crazy stunts to try to fit in. But this Chris kid is so annoying. You just feel bad for Johnny that he has to learn to like this kid just for his grandpa's sake. He's so angry and rude. Johnny is being so nice, even trying to do stuff that he's into. There's a part of the movie where he's talking with his grandpa and just saying he's trying his best to see the goodness, and it's not working. In the first movie, Johnny got angry because he couldn't be friends with the snowboarders, but now he just can't get someone to like him. This is how you know Johnny is into his toughest challenge. But Val sure likes him, and they get all along well, and she even invites him and Sam to her house and see how rich she is. Remember in the first movie, Brett was like the villain of this movie? But this time, it's not a kid that's the same age as Johnny. We see Troy, he's in charge of all these mountain boarders and has his own store. Kinda weird to see a grown man butting heads with a teenager. And just like the first movie, the end is a race against Troy. Well, this is a sequel, so it makes sense to race someone more experienced, but obviously Johnny wins. Isn't it pretty cool how Johnny barely takes on these new sports and suddenly becomes really good at them in a span of just a movie? Maybe it's just that great and cool. Maybe it's all the positive energy and kindness he has that brings out all the best in him. It's how him and Chris finally start to get along towards the end as well. The wedding happens and everybody is happy. The second movie is good, but to me it's nowhere near as good as the first movie. But most of the main cast came back with new neat additions, so these two are both definitely worth watching. Now, here's a crazy idea. Should there be a Johnny Tsunami 3? Which sport would he do? There's plenty he could do, and I think the world today needs to see a character like Johnny again. It's rare to see people that are genuinely nice and always positive and not bitter and angry at life. It probably won't happen, but we at least got these two movies to watch forever.